फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग. माई सेल्फ निधि घेटिया फ्रॉम फैकल्टी ऑफ फार्मेसी, डॉक्टर सुभाष टेक्निकल कैंपस. टुडे वी स्टडी दी अवर न्यू सब्जेक्ट, दैट इज फार्माकोग्नोसी एंड फाइटोकेमिस्ट्री 2. ओके, सो दैट्स कॉल्ड दिस BP 503 TP. ओके, इन दिस सब्जेक्ट वी लर्न दी अवर फर्स्ट यूनिट, दैट इज मेटाबॉलिक पाथवेज इन हायर प्लांट्स एंड देयर डिटर्मिनेशन. ओके, सो in last lecture we covers the introduction of the basic metabolic pathway. So today's our study of the content, that is succinic acid pathway. Okay, so first we learn the introduction of the succinic acid. Okay, so what is succinic acid? Succinic acid is also known as the succimate in its ionic form. Okay, anionic form that's known as a succinic acid is succimate. Okay, structurally is it is a cyclohexane, a cyclitol and a cyclohexane carboxylic acid. Okay, succinic acid it's having a carboxylic, that's having a ring structure. So cyclohexane carboxylic acid, that's NAM. Okay, so it is a important biochemical metabolites in plants and microorganism. Okay, succinic acid pathway, succinic acid that is important for the biochemical metabolites in the plants and microorganisms. Its name is derived from the Japanese plant, that succimi. Okay, Ileum any stem, that's name, plant's name, that is a succimi. Succinic acid is a first isolated in this plant in 1885. By John Frederick Eichem, Eichmann. So, some hydrolyzable tannins produced from the succinic acid as a glycoside part. Okay, some hydrolyzable tannins are produced by the succinic acid pathway by glycosidic part. Okay, and then succinic acid pathways is utilized by the bacteria, fungi, allies, parasites and plants for the biosynthesis of aromatic amino acid like phenylamine, then tyrosine and then tryptophan. Okay, then this acid pathway not found in an animal. This is only for the plants, not for the plant animals. Okay, animal can synthesize the tyrosine from phenylamine, and therefore it is not a essential amino acid except for the individual who unable to hydroxylate phenylamine to tyrosine. Okay, animals are not having this pathway, that is succinic acid pathway. Okay, only and only for the plants. Now we start the succinic acid pathway. First we learn the introduction of the succinic acid pathway. Now we start the succinic acid pathway. So in this succinic acid pathway is related to the metabolism of the carbohydrate and aromatic amino acid. Okay, this pathway is related to metabolism of the carbohydrates and aromatic amino acids. So this pathway constitute the 7 step, starting with the condensation of the phosphoenol pyruvate and erythrophosphate. Okay, starting from the phosphoenol pyruvate and erythrophosphate, and its pathway that having the 7 step procedure. Okay, in condensation process are followed. First, starting with the condensation process. So their condensation and cyclolization leads to the formation of the succinic acid and end with the synthesis of the crosmic acid. Okay, so active form of this with coenzyme A, that is a coenzyme A. Okay, and can access the main classes of the phenolic compound, quanting some transforming to the acid of the benzoic acid like gallic and protocatechute, like by the beta oxidation process. Okay, active forms of this with coenzyme A can be access the main classes of phenolic compounds and quanting some transformation to acid of the benzoic acid like gallic and protochoic. Okay, protochoic by the beta oxidation process. Then gallic acid itself, its combination of with simple sugar leads to the hydrolyzable tannins like gallic and elagic tannins. Okay, gallic and elagic tannins. Or after the addition of the molecules of phosphoenol pyruvate and additional series of the intermediates like sters, follows by the amination, gives a rise to aromatic amino acid like tyrosine and phenylamine. The starting point of the phenylamine, phenylpropionamide's pathway. Okay, so starting from the phenylpropionamide propanoid pathway. Okay, so in this process, amination process are the followed and rising to the aromatic amino acid like tyrosine and phenylamine. Okay, so intermediate state, that is, that's making the succinic acid. So that's why this pathway is known as the succinic acid pathway. Okay, so in this, first we take the phosphoenol pyruvic acid and erythrose for phosphate. Okay, after in the process, that making the 2-keto-3-deoxy-7-phosphodiglucoheptanoic acid. And then further process then generates the 3-dehydroquinic acid and then 3-dehydrosicimic acid. Sicimic acid are generated. Further decomposition and making the sicimic acid. After the sicimic acid, 1-phosphate molecule are attached and making the sicimic acid 3-phosphate. Okay, and then chromic acid also generated. After the chromic acid decomposition making the prephenic acid and chromic acid also convert in anthranilic acid and anthranilic acid phosphorylation process are follows there and series of the tryptophan. Okay, so last product of the chromic acid after anthranilic acid and tryptophan. And prephenic acid, two pathway are different form in chromic acid and here first anthranilic acid and second one, that is a prephenic acid. So in prephenic acid, two molecules are generated. First one, that is a phenyl pyruvic acid and a para hydroxy phenyl pyruvic acid. Okay, two molecules are generated. First one, that is a phenyl pyruvic acid. And second one, that is a p-hydroxy. Hydroxy group are attached at the para position of the phenyl pyruvic acid. And after the reduction of the amination and making the phenyl alanine and tyrosine. Okay, so last product, that is a phenyl alanine and tyrosine. Okay, starting from this pathway with phosphoenol pyruvic acid and erythrose for phosphate and then ending of this pathway, that is a phenylalanine and tyrosine, also the tryptophan from chromic acid. Okay, so this is a 7-step pathway. So now we study this step in deep. Okay, so succinic acid pathway, phenol, phosphoenol pyruvate and erythrose for phosphate react to the form 2-keto-3-deoxy-7-phosphoglucoheptanoic acid in the reaction catalyzed by the enzyme, that is a DAHP synthesis. Okay, DAHP synthesis, that is a enzyme. Okay, so this all the reaction are followed in a presence of the any enzymes. Okay, so second step, that is a 2-keto-3-deoxy-7-phosphoglucoheptanoic acid is then transformed to 3-dehydroquinate, that is a DHQ. Okay, so in this reaction catalyzed by the DHQ synthesis. Okay, this DHQ, that is a dehydroxyquinate synthesis, that is an enzyme catalyzed, are present in the 2 keto 3 dioxy 7 phosphor glucoheptanoic acid transport to dehydroquinone. Okay, and then although this reaction require the nicotinamides adenine and dinucleotides, that is A and AD, okay, and AD as a cofactors, present as a cofactors. Okay, and then the enzymatic mechanism regenerates the, its result is in the net use of the number of NAD, that is the energy. Okay, nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, that is the NAD. Okay, is one form of the energy, NAD. And then first product, that is a phosphoenol pyruvic acid plus erythrose 4 phosphate, that's convert in a 2 keto 3 deoxy 7 phosphor 7-phosphor-D glucoheptanoic acid in the presence of the DAHP synthesis. Okay, and then further DHQ synthesis enzyme are present and 2-keto-3-deoxy-7-phosphor-D glucoheptanoic acid transport to 3D dehydroquinic acid, okay, or quinate. Now third step, that is a 3DHQ, that is a dehydroxyquinic acid, is hydrated to 3-dehydroxyquinic acid by the process, that is enzyme 3-hydroquinate dehydratase. Enzyme that is a 3-dehydroquinate dehydratase are present in between the DHQ, that is a dehydroquinic acid, and dehydroxyquinic acid, okay, which convert in a succinic acid in the presence of this enzyme, and with the reduce the succinic acid by the enzyme, that is a succinate dehydrogenase. Okay, in the DHQ are convert in a dehydroxyquinic acid in the presence of the 3-dehydroquinate dehydratase, okay, that is the enzyme, and then dehydroxyquinic acid are convert in the succinic acid in the presence of the succinate dehydrogenase enzyme, okay, which use the nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate, that is the NADPH, as a cofactor, that is a cofactor also the produce the energy. Okay, and the next step, that is a next enzyme involved in a succinate kinase and enzyme that catalyze the ATP and depends the phosphorylation of the succinate to form the succinate 3-phosphate. Okay, and then succinate 3-phosphate is then the couple with the phosphoenol pyruvate to gives the 5-enol pyruvyl succinate 3-phosphate via the enzyme 5-enol pyruvyl succinic acid succinate 3-phosphate EPSP synthesis, that is the enzyme's name, EPSP, short form of the enzyme name, enol pyruvyl succinate 3-phosphate synthesis, that is the enzyme's name. Okay, so then 5-enol pyruvyl succinate 3-phosphate is transferred in the crossmat by the crorismat synthesis. Okay, then succinic acid are converted in a succinic acid 3-phosphate are the attached. Okay, and then after the dehydrogenase process are follows and crossmic acid are generated. Okay, so prepheonic acid is then synthesis by the Claisen rearrangement of the crossmate by the crossmate mutase, that is the enzyme's name. Okay, so crossmic acid and prepheonic acid. After the making prepheonic acid, phenyl pyruvic acid and para hydroxy phenyl pyruvic acid, two molecules are generated. first one that is not having a OH group, and second para hydroxyphenyl pyruvic acid that's having the OH group in a para position. Okay, and then after the reductive amination process are follows here, and NH2 groups are the attached both side. So first phenyl pyruvic acid that generate the phenyl alanine, and para hydroxyphenyl pyruvic acid that generate the tyrosine. Okay, with addition of the amine group, phenyl alanine and tyrosine are making. So prephenant is oxidatively decarboxylate with the retention of the hydroxyl group by the prephenate dehydrogenase. Okay, retention of the hydroxyl group to the para hydroxy phenyl pyruvate, by which is transmitted using the glutamate as the nitrogen source to give tyrosine and alpha ketoglutarate. Okay, so this is a succinic acid pathway. Now we study the role of the succinic acid pathway. So starting point of the in the biosynthesis of the some phenolic phenyl alanine and the tyrosine, and the precursor used in the biosynthesis of the phenyl propionamide. Okay, starting point of the biosynthesis of the some phenolic phenyl alanine and the tyrosine are the precursor as used in the biosynthesis of the phenyl propionoid. Okay, and then the phenyl propionoid are then used to the produce the flavonoids, coumarins, tannins and lysinins. Okay, phenyl propionoids are used to produce in the flavonoids, coumarins and tannins and also lysinin. Okay, so gallic acid's biosynthesis by gallic acid is formed from 3-dehydrosikimate by the action of the enzyme that is sikimate dehydrogenase to produce the 3,5-dihydrosikimate. Okay, they produce the dihydrosikimate by the enzyme that is sikimate dehydrogenase from the gallic acid from the 3-dehydrosikimate. Okay, and later compound that is spontaneously rearranged to the gallic acid. Then other compounds like the succinic acid is used as a precursor. Okay, as a precursor. And then indole and indole derivatives and aromatic amino acid like tryptophan and tryptophan derivatives, such as the psychedelic compounds like the any compounds are used as a psycho products. Okay, compounds dimethyl tryptamine and many alkaloids and other aromatic metabolites. Okay, other compounds like succinic acid used as a precursor in indoles and indole derivatives, and also aromatic amino acid like tryptophan and tryptophan derivatives. Okay, so our psychedelic compounds like dimethyl tryptamine and many alkaloids and other aromatic metabolites. Okay, so last, that is the role of the succinic acid pathway. That so first one that is a pentose pathway, starting from the pentose and glycosides, glycolysis process also follows here. Okay, so first that is a erythrose 4-phosphate and enol pyruvate. Okay, phosphoenol pyruvate and erythrose 4-phosphate, and intermediate state that is a succinic acid produce the succinic acid. After the succinic acid produce, they making the phenyl alanine. Then after cinnaminic acid, then coumarin acid produce, and a further decomposition, they making the ferulic acid, and then last that is a lysinin. Okay, and after the cinnaminic acid, three process are follows there. Three products are making. First one, that is a coumarin. Second one, that is a coumaric acid, and third one, that is a flavonoids. Okay, and condensation of the flavonoids process are follows and making the condensed tannins. Okay, succinic acid pathway. Succinic acid also produce the tyrosine. So tyrosine further decomposition and making the 4OH, like 4OH, like 4 number position OH group are attached, and 4OH cinnaminic acid, that is a para coumaric acid. Okay, then also succinic acid also generate the gallic acid, and they generate the hydrolyzable tannins. Okay, and also tryptophan also generated, they generate the alkaloids and indole 3 acetic acid, indole or indole derivatives. Okay, so first we start the erythrophosphate, that is a pentose. Okay, pentose pathway. From erythros 4 phosphate are generated from the pentose pathway, and enol pyruvate that generated from the glycolysis process. After the both process are complete, then make then both molecules are the attached, erythro-4-phosphate and phosphoenol pyruvate. Okay, then further the steps are the follows one by one and making the succinic acid. This is a succinic acid pathway because the intermediate product, that is a succinic acid. So that's why succinic acid pathway known as the succinic acid pathway. Okay, so succinic acid, they making the four products, like first one, that is a tyrosine, second one, that is a phenylamine, third one, that is a tryptophan, fourth one, that is a gallic acid, and also generate the protocatechuic acid. Okay, so in tyrosine are further decomposition and OH are attached in their structure at a para position. So cinnaminic acid are also known as the paracoumaric acid. Okay, and after the phenylamine, phenylalanine, they generate the cinnaminic acid, and after the cinnaminic acid, they generate the three components. Okay, so first one, that is a coumarin, second one, that is a paracoumaric acid, and third one, that is a flavonoids. Okay, so phenylalanine in the presence of the PAL, that is an enzyme. Okay, PAL, that is an enzyme, making the cinnaminic acid. Cinnaminic acid also generate the three products, like coumarin, paracoumaric acid, and flavonoids. Okay, so coumarin, paracoumaric acid also further decomposition in any synthesis like enzymes. Okay, and further decomposition and making the further reaction are follows and making the lignin. Okay, lignin. Then flavonoids also decomposed and making the condensed tannin. Okay, then third one, that is a tryptophan. Tryptophan are making the alkaloids and indole derivatives. Indole and indole derivatives. Okay, then gallic acid are generate the hydrolyzable tannins. So this is a succinic acid overview of the succinic acid pathway. Now we see the uses of the succinic acid pathway. So in the pharmaceutical industry, succinic acid forms the Chinese star anis, Illicium vernum. Okay, that is the name of the Chinese star anise. Is used as a base material for the production of the Ostelamivir, that is a Tamiflu. Used as a Tamiflu, that is a Ostelamivir. Okay, then targeted drugs like Sikimet can be used to synthesize the 6S, that is a 6-fluorosicmic acid, and antibiotics which inhibits the aromatic biosynthesis synthetic pathways. Okay, and then glyphosphate, the active ingredient in the hybrid herbicide Roundup, kills plant by the interfering with the cycamate pathway in the plant. More specifically, glyphosate inhibits the enzyme pyinol pyruvyl cycamate 3 phosphate synthesis, that is a enzyme EPSPS. Then Roundup Red is genetically modified the crops overcome the that inhibition. Okay, any hybridized glyphosate also used as a hybridicidal. Okay, so in a plant and interfering the cycamic acid pathway in the perform in a plants, and then more specifically glyphosate are inhibit the enzymes, that is a EPSP, as that is a 5-enol pyruvyl cycamate 3 phosphate synthesis. Okay, and then Roundup Ready to genetically modify the crops overcome the in that inhibition. Okay, so today we learn the our second topic, that is a cycamic acid pathway. So thank you to all.